Important bills on the agenda for today, and I want to thank my colleagues for offering their legislation to improve the care and services we provide to veterans. After reading the witnesses' prepared statements ahead of today's hearing, I would also like to extend a special thank you to each of the VSOs for supporting my legislation, H.R. 93, that will ensure women veterans have access to gender-specific services at VA facilities. The Women Veteran Equal Access to Quality Care Act will increase access to health care for the ever-growing population of women veterans enrolled in VA care by requiring the department to offer gender-specific services at each of its medical facilities. This legislation is critical to ensure that women veterans receive the equal access to health care that they have earned. Almost 10% of the total veteran population, over 2 million veterans, are women, and the VA projects that this percentage will continue to rise. In the years since 9/11, more American women have served our country in uniform than ever before. Nearly 280,000 women have served in Iraq and Afghanistan, and through their service have earned the full range of health care services provided by the VA. We must ensure that our nation's women veterans have access to the full range of health care services that they need, including dedicated women's health providers and gender-specific care. I'm also eager to hear from our witnesses about the two pieces of legislation related to service dog therapy on the agenda today. Both the PAWS Act and the Veteran Dog Training Therapy Act serve as important discussion points in ensuring VA is exploring the efficacy of alternative forms of treatment, especially treatments that have seemingly obvious benefits. I have yet to meet a veteran assigned a service dog that did not appreciate the assistance and therapy offered by the dog. We must continue to look at these complementary and alternative treatments that help veterans cope with the invisible wounds of war. I welcome the input of the VA and our VSOs so that we can continue to work together to develop the best legislation that will achieve this purpose. Mr. Chairman, thank you for the opportunity to discuss the legislation in front of the committee today, and I yield back.